Hello everyone, I'm Matthew Ryan Moore and I am a teen with high functioning autism, ADD, and a tic disorder. And in today's episode of Living and Learning with Autism, I'm going to be explaining eye contact. How does eye contact affect me? What are some things I have done to help me make eye contact, etc. To begin, when people talk to us, we are supposed to be making eye contact with them. Making eye contact shows that you are paying attention to what they have to say and you care about what they have to say, right? But now with individuals with autism like myself, we find it difficult to give eye contact. Almost all individuals with autism have that issue. One of the biggest signs for diagnosing someone with autism, the sign to look for is their eye contact. Now I am going to go ahead and explain why it is hard for someone with autism to make eye contact. It's kind of hard to explain, but I will do my best explaining that. So, for me, it feels like I'm using up a lot of energy. The longest I can stare at someone in the eye is from less than 2 to 6 seconds at the most. Then it gets tiring. It often feels like I'm being blocked mentally from giving eye contact. Something stops me, something is forcing me not to make eye contact. At one time, I used to get a feeling of embarrassment when making eye contact. I used to feel like someone was seeing right through me. It felt weird and it felt awkward. Eye contact was like an awkward moment for me. So the best advice I can give people who want to make it an effort to make eye contact is to practice doing it. Whenever I'm in a situation where I have to give someone eye contact, for example, if I'm one-on-one with someone or in a serious conversation with someone, I force myself to do it. Even if it lasts me 2 seconds, I'm still making it an effort. I might look at that person's eyes 2 seconds. I might look down 2 seconds. I look back up 2 seconds. Down 2 seconds. I shake my head a little bit. Oh yeah, you know, respond to them. That's the best way to show people you care, you're paying attention to what they have to say. People with autism have to make it an effort to give eye contact. It's a part of interacting with people. It's a huge instrument for communication. Some people are like, oh, how rude, he's not making eye contact with me. It's not that I'm being rude. That's my disability, but that's still no excuse. You have to make it an effort. You have to let yourself know that that person is not seeing right through you. It's not possible. There's never been a case where someone had x-ray vision and they could see right through someone unless you're a conspiracy theorist. Just saying. Eye contact is a part of communicating with people. Yes, it does take a lot of force, a lot of energy for us individuals with autism, but it's something we have to do. So that's my view on eye contact. I tried to explain it the best I could. I hope it helps you guys. And yeah, I thank everyone for watching. And stay tuned for next week's episode of Living and Learning with Autism. Merry Christmas, Happy Hanukkah, Happy New Year, bye. Bye.